Hey guys, it's Queendija, and in today's video, I will be reacting to episode 12 of Undead Unluck. It's gonna get started in 3, 2, 1, go. There we go. Hooray! BTW, one more thing. If you hear beeping in the background, I'm sorry. Our fire alarm is being dumb. We've changed the battery and everything, and it's just being stupid. Did I have it too tight? I kinda did. The way they just killed those two. Oh my god. Just so quickly. I mean, dang. Y'all can't go anywhere. It's the day before Christmas. Everything's closed. Oh. I mean, you think the gun's gonna stop him? God. Gonna get a different opening today too, but damn, no, I'm guessing that's episode 13, which that's okay because I still like this opening. It's a damn good song, so but yeah, but you know how like when you're ready to hear something new, but at the same time you still want to hear the old song because the old song's good as fuck. Like, see, that was me like with JJK season 2. Like I loved the song from like the first 4 or 5 episodes, and then you know we go from that to special, and I was just like, yeah, this is good, but I also miss my happiness. I don't want to go into depression. And depression I went into, like, oh my god. He probably doesn't even know. My mom. Oh, wouldn't you like to know? But you're probably about to get killed in a second. Oh. He screwed. If only you could just go back in time. Need to light fireworks. That ain't even New Year's. Jesus Christ. But there is no act, though. Oh my! Poor baby. Yeah, just wait and see me, Andy. You might. Oh my God, what the fuck was that? Oh, damn. But not with violence, though. I mean, yeah, I get it. Sometimes violence is the answer, but no, he does baby. Oh my God. Wait, I mean, this is a little messed up. I mean, well, hold up. Then we just don't care about anybody. don't really think so. Oh. Where did he go? But damn. No, it's okay. He fine. I'm over this kid. Oh my God. Baby, he hates God. I'm just gonna be like, No. Okay, I get that, but maybe with time and practice, he could utilize his stuff. Like, dang. I mean, yeah, he's a little new and such, but Jesus. Not the blood in the hair, though. Oh my God. Girl, you better get the fuck up. You just made out with this man a couple episodes ago. Oh my God. She just woke back up after making out with him. And now she got an hour to live. Oh my God. No, it's not. Well, one of two, but yeah. This is a good episode. Except the fact that Fuko is literally bleeding, she might die in an hour. So, you know, we need to fix that ASAP. It is hot in here. But I feel for this kid, like, oof. Just to think, like, oh my god. And this can happen to, like, any kid. Guy, girl, whoever. Bruh. Literally, one minute, you just living this, like, normal, everyday, happy-go-lucky life. And the next thing you know, like, in a snap, everything changes. And next thing you know, someone's running after you and you're getting captured. Initially, I thought, ugh. That's a lot for a kid. And I get it. Like, poor baby. He didn't want to be around Gore or anything. I thought that was so fucking cute. Because, I mean, I have friends. I have friends who cannot watch the crap out of horror films. Because they don't like Gore. And I'm just over here like, you can't watch horror movies with me. I've been like, come on. Yeah, it'll be fun. Don't be a scaredy cat. And I'm like, I can't do it either. I'm like, you just think of it as like, Jello or ketchup or I don't know, pudding. But his ability is really interesting though. Aww. Thank god, I need a whole episode on her because she's just too freaking adorable and I want to know like why she is in that and stuff, because you would think that we would actually get to see what she looks like. But ever since she's popped up, I'm like, why is she in a... I mean, we could say Magic 8 Ball without it being a Magic 8 Ball. But I was like, yeah, why is she stuck in that? Is it because, like... I wouldn't say her ability is, like, similar to Fuko's. But, like, with Fuko's, like, no matter who she touches, like, instant death regardless and such. But I'm guessing with her, maybe her ability is just that dangerous or something. But... here's hoping that we get a little more exclamation on that. That's the thing. But yeah, this was an interesting episode for what it was. Excuse me. Now, our villains, aka the ones who wanted to kill this kid. I would like to maybe see an episode on their POV and such. Because, I mean, we're always only really getting, like, this teeny tiny snippet. And then that's it. They kind of did that, especially when we got into the start of the real arc and such. But I want them to do like they did, even though I don't watch the show anymore. And I don't even think I'm going to watch season 7 of said show. How they did Shigaraki. And such, like, they gave Shigaraki like so much freaking backstory and stuff, which thank god, because that was something that I wanted for years ever since I watched season 1. But yeah, because they like all four of them, they feel like really interesting characters, and they're only giving us like the scratch of the surface, so we're not getting like the whole thing, we're just getting this, like, I can say, I'm trying to think of a food. You're getting, like, this small little amount of mac and cheese when you want the whole freaking mac and cheese with yams and everything else. And such, you want that whole meal. You want everything. So hopefully we get that in the next couple of weeks. But, yeah, this was a really interesting episode. But other than that, guys, that is my reaction towards episode 11 of Undead Unluck. If you guys enjoyed it, please give me a like. It really helps me out. Also, subscribe to my channel. I make videos every single day. Join the Mush Squad. And of course, I will see you guys officially all next Friday. Really more, of course, Saturday. Because you know this ain't coming out until like 3 hours in the freaking morning. For episode 13. But until then, I will see you guys all next time. Bye.